Hey everyone, Shawn Clement here, Wisdom in Golf, and we've got just an incredibly important video for you today. We're going to show you how you're gripping the hammer, gripping the baseball bat, and gripping the golf club have so much in common, and it greatly affects the way your hands are at address. And so many of you are trying to adjust to the golf club instead of taking a proper grip. And it really is destroying any capability that you have to compress the golf ball. The grip is the compression chamber of the golf swing. Ball speed and smash factor depend on it. You don't want to miss this video. Before we continue, of course, if Moo and Sav were here, we would be telling you to, hey, please subscribe to the channel and leave a comment or question down below and ring that notification bell so you don't miss another video of ours because they're really good. Now, there's some rain coming. I have my umbrella. Notice how I'm holding my umbrella? When I ask many of my students, how do you grip an umbrella? They go here and I'm going, well, you're kind of going to get wet. So if you don't want to get wet, you notice you have to hold the umbrella through and perpendicular to the center of the hand, meaning not the center of the palm, the center of the hand where the fingers join the grip or the hand right here. See that? And the heel pad is right there on top. Now you just have to put your thumb on top. You'd normally have your thumb on the side for baseball. It's exactly the same in baseball. When you hold your baseball bat and you're getting ready, you're waiting for the pitch, notice how that lead hand is right perpendicular to the baseball bat. Both hands, now I'm in a great position to play ball. Notice how you would never hold the bat like this. I mean, you would never hold that to bunt either. This is a very weak position of the bat. You can't hinge your wrists from there. I see too many of you doing that. And the reason being is you take the golf club and you try to hold it flat against the ground. You think that the sole of the club needs to be flush with the ground. Notice now that puts the club right through the center of the hand. Instead of take your umbrella there. Now you notice when I'm hinging my wrist on that anatomical snuff box, the point of my wrist here where the is right above the tip of my thumb. See how my thumb is coming in from a 1 o'clock position back to noon. The tip of the thumb is almost on noon. And there's where my wrist is hinging on that anatomical snuff box. So here I can hinge beautifully. Here I can't. My hand is kind of locked up and I got this big gap, a big hole right there. And so you're trying to hold the club in line. So now notice my forearms are with the club and this gives me very little compression. And for many of you, it causes your hands to cramp up and you're going to get all kinds of tension in your hands, in your elbows. Many of you've got golfers' elbows. That's because your grip has been compromised. So let's look at a household hammer. See my household hammer? This I can hammer nails with. This I'm just tapping nails, right? I can just tap. This is not powerful. This is very powerful, very compressive. So now I have a compression chamber to slam that nail into the board. So when you take this particular grip, very important, put the other hand on, you'll notice when you get into your posture that your hands are much lower. They're much more underneath your posture. Early extension, anyone? When you're up here, you're slapping at the ball. When you're down here, you're compressing through the golf ball. Notice the toe of the club is in the air. These are properly fit clubs for me. When the club stops coming down and comes back up again on the other side, gravity is pulling down on this club. This is a stiff shaft. It's a rifle stiff shaft. They're very rigid shafts. Notice how there's a lot of give in that shaft, and that's going to come and sit the club down on the ground. So you'll notice that from this posture here, this looks like a great posture for me to cut grass with. So when I'm cutting grass, hear the sound of that sucker? That is so compressed versus if I'm standing up already with my grip, and then I take that club, and now my hands are all compromised. I feel like there's all kinds of air pockets going on in there. And if I try to swing from there, my wrists can't form properly. I'll start to collapse in the wrists, or I'll have a tendency to collapse in the other way. So this is a cup collapse. This is a bow collapse versus a proper hinge. Notice when it's hinging, it looks like it's a little bit cupped, but it's not. It's properly hinged on both snuff boxes. Okay? So I get into a posture. The ultimate way that the ball is going to get airborne is if you strike it in the center of the club face. Well, in order for you to do that, notice the sole of the club has to be in the grass. Well, if you're thinking about hitting the ball, you're up here trying to hit the ball, well, you're going to come up to hit the ball. The brain says, hey, the club's on the grass. I need to come up to hit the ball. And then you top it, get all embarrassed, and then you got to make sure to keep your head down so you don't top the ball. That's not a way to play golf. You're just worried about topping a golf ball instead of sending the ball to the target. Well, to send the ball to the target, this particular puppy here, remember, is a grass cutting tool. Let me get my grass cutting tool real quick. Boom, didn't mean to scare you. See? So I am cutting grass. See my position? I'm not going to be up here when I'm cutting grass. I got to get down to cut the grass. So now I'm cutting the grass in both directions. Hear the sound? So if I get over here and I cut through the grass, notice the ball stays right there. I just cut the stem out. That's when they say on TV, when you hear the commentators say, cutting the legs out from under the ball. Well, yeah, the grass is the legs. And you're cutting the grass underneath the ball along the ground. You can't get under the ball. You can only cut the grass out from along the ground, which is below the equator of the ball. And that's going to put the ball right in the center of that club face. So I'm focused on the sole of the club cutting grass. So when I'm setting up to the ball, my eyes are not on the ball. My eyes are on the grass between the leading edge of the club and the ball. And if you look at this video I have running right across or right beside us, you'll notice that the club comes down, hits the ball, cuts the stem. That's when the ball pops up. And then you see the club follow along the surface of the ground. So the grass is coming out after the ball's been struck, and the ball is in the air and the club is still on the ground. That's how things work. So if you want to follow the ground, you ain't going to do it from up here. You got to be down here to follow the ground. So here we go. See that? Now, if I take a wedge, and I'll show you how to stay along the ground here. Here's a little experiment that you can do. We're going to cut through two dandelion stems. It's dandelion season. So I put two golf balls about 3 to 4 inches apart right here. Stay there, you. Okay. And I'm going to cut through both dandelion stems, staying with them, staying with them. Notice how both golf balls took off. Watch that in stop action. You're going to see how cool that is. The club is staying along the ground. So if I do a practice swing here in front of these golf balls, watch where the club actually hits the ground. See that? started here, right after the stem of that dandelion, stayed along the ground all the way past the second ball. So if both golf balls can go in the air, here we go. Off they go. That's so cool. So they're right there on top of the tee box, one in the middle of the tee box and one at the end of the tee box. And they're both, basically the second one's gonna go a little bit left of the first one. It's a very, very nice exercise to do. So now when you take your 7-iron or your 4-iron or your hybrid, then you're focused on getting through that second ball. So I'm down, hands lower. When I say hands lower, it doesn't mean lower on the club. It means lower, and you notice now the hands are under your chest. So when the hands are under your chest, then you'll have a fabulous contact with the golf ball. So posture, toe in the air. Now I'm going through the stem in the direction I want that ball to start. So we gather. And there it is, just nutted right in the direction I want to go. Now it's landing. Enjoy that, you guys. Get that compression chamber put together. Look at the other videos that I have on the grip. They're very intricate. And if you really want some awesome information, go to wisdomingolfpremium.com, where you get all the goods, all the best.